So we're going to start out with measuring your head. Now the book has you measure from the top crown of your head and all the way following the curve down to the joint of your neck and your shoulder. This works really great if you know what the neckline of the garment is going to be. This is almost always where we go wrong in the first place. So you're not going to have a hood on an item that follows the neckline of your slopers, or you're not going to be able to get your head in that opening in the first place. So the very first thing you have to do is you have to decide what your neckline is going to be and how much you're going to drop it and widen it and open it. And then you measure from the crown of your head to where the opening of the neck would be, not necessarily a set anatomical point on the body. Okay? Then you're going to measure from temple to temple all the way around the back of your head. This also is pretty arbitrary based on style. Are you the kind of person who wants your hood to be right out here on your temples? Do you have a buttload of hair that always causes your hood to not fit all the way to the top of your head and is shallow all the time? In which case, put your hair in the worst case scenario, and as you're measuring from temple to temple, include that hair measurement so you know how deep this hood needs to go. Okay, so you're going to have those two measurements. Then I want you to cut those two measurements in half before we ever get started, so you know what your numbers are half scale. And then you're going to cut your circumference in half again, because we're only working with half of the hood. So do that math first.